Let us study about the magnetic induction due to a finite length wire. In previous sections, we have already studied about magnetic induction due to an infinite and a semi-infinite wire. Now, let's consider there is a finite length wire AB which carries a current I. And from this wire AB at a perpendicular distance R, there exists a point P. From point O on wire, and we are required to find the magnetic induction at P. Direction can be directly given in downward direction because of this right hand thumb rule. And so we are also given that if the point P is joined with the edges of wire A and B, these angles subtended by A and B at P are say theta 2 and theta 1. Then we can find out the magnetic induction by using Bio-Savart's law, for which we consider a small element of length dl on the wire. And rather than using a Cartesian system, let's proceed it in a slightly different way. Here at an angle theta from line OP, we consider an element of angular width d theta. The length of this wire is say r naught, then length of distance of point P from this element dl is r naught, then r naught can be given as r by cos theta. And we can relate this length with the element of length dl, like if we drop a perpendicular here, this distance we can write as r by cos theta d theta. And if this element is of length dl, then the same length can be written as dl cos theta. From here we can get the value of dl, which is r by cos square theta d theta. And if dB is the magnetic induction at point P due to this element of length dl, then we can write magnetic induction due to dl at P, dB is given as, this can be obtained by using Bio-Savart's law, as dB is mu naught upon 4 pi I dl. Dl we can write as r by cos square theta d theta multiplied by sine theta. So if this angle we talk about, if this theta, this pi by 2 minus theta, it can be written as cos theta divided by this r naught square, which can be written as r by cos theta whole square. So in this situation, you can see this cos square theta gets cancelled out. The value of dB on simplifying we are getting is mu naught I by 4 pi r cos theta d theta. Now for total magnetic induction at P, we can write BP is integration of dB, which is written as mu naught I by 4 pi r is a constant. I can take it out of the sign of integration, this cos theta d theta. If we apply the limits, then limits will apply on theta, which will be from minus theta 2 to plus theta 1. On integrating, we are getting the value of magnetic induction at point P as mu naught I by 4 pi r. Integration of cos theta will be sin theta. If we substitute the limits, this will be sin theta 1 minus of sin of minus theta 2, which is plus sin theta 2. So this is the magnetic induction at point P due to a finite length wire. Sometimes we are given with a situation in which a wire carries a current I, and at point P, rather than angle subtended by the edges A and B, it is given that point P subtend angles alpha and beta at points A and B, which are correspondingly pi by 2 minus theta 2 and pi by 2 minus theta 1. So in this situation, magnetic induction can be written as mu naught I by 4 pi r. This can be written as cos alpha plus cos beta. I'm using the same result, just replacing theta 2 by pi by 2 minus alpha and theta 1 as pi by 2 minus beta. So you must be careful about these results, which are the magnetic induction due to a finite length wire in the surrounding direction, can be simply obtained by using right hand thumb rule.